Prologue. Awake at last.
Tick tock, tick tock. Tick tock, tick tock. Tick tock. Time to wake up.
I gotta get to work. Oh, am I gonna make it? The boss hates when I'm late. Then again, it's not like business has picked up any. Maybe we should start selling sandwiches along with the coffee. The streets sure are quiet today. Hey, I'm here.
Huh? How'd she get in if no one's here yet?
Good morning. I'm real sorry. I hope you haven't been waiting long.
Huh?
Right. She needs some water.
Oh, no thanks. A pint. I mean, a cup of coffee, please. Oh, and bring the whole jar of sugar. I'm gonna need it.
Right. That's one cup of joe. And I'll get you one of the big jars. Has nobody made the coffee yet? Come on, get it together, guys. I'm sorry, miss. This might take a while.
Hey, no hurry. Time's not an issue.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Sure. Your age, huh?
Hey, don't talk down to me. Listen, last time I checked, little bro, I've been around a few minutes longer than you.
Okay. I get it already.
Very sorry.
So, what's up? I'm all ears.
Well, you don't have to get all sarcastic.
You really are all ears.
What?
Forget it. Solon, have you seen anybody this morning?
Well, yeah. I mean, I'm looking right at you, aren't I? And there's that customer.
What?
Ah! Oh, hello!
You didn't even see her? Dude.
Yeah, but... Ah! Look! Come with me right now!
Easy! Quick! Ow, 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 ow!
Nobody here!
So it's a quiet morning. Maybe they just...
I mean no one!
Huh?
Lon, have you bumped into anyone today besides her?
Now that you mention it, I guess not.
And this isn't setting off any alarms?
Well, should it?
You two really don't remember a thing.
Huh? What was that? Who are you? If you're from around town, then I don't know you.
Rain Manners.
You two really don't remember a thing.
Would you please just answer my question?
You can call me Anna Crow. Anna Crow will work.
Okay, well... We woke up to a ghost town this morning. Maybe you know why?
Yes, you're quite alone. But you always have been.
Huh?
This world, it's always been the two of you. A world without time. One that ended when it began.
What? That's the weirdest thing I've heard.
But don't worry. Just because the world ended doesn't mean that it's going anywhere.
You know, I have been checking up on you two.
Until now, you were nothing but blank stares. So imagine my surprise when Lon took my order. What a morning.
Okay. Now you're kind of scaring me.
So, now that you're awake, we've got a story to tell. Which brings us to... Tama!
Right here!
Who the hog put this thing on my head?
Yeah, I did try to mention it before. You take it from here. I'll go on ahead and link up a path.
You the daddy!
Huh? Hey! You can't just leave!
Salutations! The name is Tama, and I'm here to help out. Does anyone have any questions?
Wait, I've got tons of questions! Why were you sitting on my head? And how the hell can a fox even talk?
That's the seriously the first thing on your mind? Now I see why Inna Crow is just about the ready to throw in the towel.
We're not allowed to be confused!
Hey, whoa, take it easy there, Lon.
I thought you were upset,
Let's
too!
Let's start the over. I'll make us some of the coffee.
Huh? Oh, yes, please.
But I already made some coffee before you got here. How can you just roll with this rain?
Chill the owl. You live the much longer.
Yeah, Lon. You shouldn't start out your morning with so much stress.
Oh, would you like some sugar?
3 cubes for you, right, Lon?
Huh?
I'm good with just one.
No.
Okay, I'll have to go and put the coffee on.
But I just said I...
You know what? Just give me my dang cup of coffee. Mirage Keepers? Me and Rain?
That's the correct. Those the marks on your arms are proof. You were born to work the miracles.
Miracles? Our arms can do that?
Dude.
How could you forget? You used to command a whole legion of them. You were masters of them. Powerful living illusions known as mirages. In the fact, even the Pleiad answered to you, and those are the 7 strongest mirages of all. With their power, you could have the ruled over all the world.
Oh. So, we could have ruled the world? Because, what, we controlled these mirages?
Well, that's what I've heard.
From who?
What do you mean? Inna Crow that told me, of course. But enough the reminiscing. I've got to teach you two to use mirages again.
What? How's that?
First off, I'm going to present you with my very own Prismarium.
So what does it do?
With this Prismarium, the mirage inside becomes yours. And you can make it do to anything and everything you command. So let's try it right now in glorious combat.
Wait, what? Huh?
Also known as AP. You automatically gain a little bit of AP each the time your turn comes around in battle. The amount of AP you need depends on the what you're trying to do, so make sure you use them wisely. had talent? Figure it out yet? The two of you were unsurpassed. No, the Mirage could stand up to you.
Dude, seriously?
Dude, but seriously.
It's hard to believe.
I'm sure it is. As far as I can tell, you two have lost everything. All the memories and experience you've ever accumulated.
Oh, but wait. Of course that would have happened when you and this world were spliced out.
Huh? So not only did they lose the Mirages they had, they've been stripped of all their memories of the Mirages, too? But I guess that explains why all their other memories seem to be largely unaffected.
What?
Listen, let me show you something. There, just beyond this light, lies another world called Grimoire. That is where you'll find all the Mirages you've lost.
You mean they're all inside this gate?
You got it. Are you ready to conquer them again?
So, if we do manage to find all the lost Mirages, does that mean we'll be able to remember the things we forgot?
Well, I don't know about that. After all, you lost your memories. It's not the same thing as forgetting them.
Oh.
But even if you don't remember Grimoire, Grimoire still knows a lot about you. You're certain to find traces and records of your past.
Okay, so like...
You're saying whether we remember anything about ourselves or not, we can still find clues about our past and the things we've done?
Correct. And if you keep on gathering Mirages, I think you might even meet your family in due time.
Our family?
Huh? Well, I guess. It does make sense that we'd have parents.
Oh, yes. So then, you going? You going? Will you journey to Grimoire? Chapter 1. Land of the Lilikin.
So, this must be Grimoire.
What?
Must look. Inna Crow just wanted to make sure you had a nice and a handy way of blending in.
Wow, she can do stuff like that?
That is awesomely weird.
Well, this kind of works out. We won't have anybody gawking at our arms.
Way to find the silver lining. I guess we should head straight down this path?
It's the only direction we can go. Think you can manage to not get lost? You know, just this once?
What? I'm not gonna get lost. Yet. Oh, hello. I spy another mirage.
That is the call to Choco Chick. What are you the waiting for? Go on and imprison the it.
Okay.
Sort of like a prismarium. What is it?
That's the call to prism. Use it to make the Choco Chicks prismarium. Every time you find a new the mirage you haven't seen before, it'll be recorded in Enna Crow's special mirage manual.
Whoa! Does it even have pictures?
You the betcha. And then whenever you add a new mirage to the manual, you receive one of its prisms. But only the first time, mind you. Okay, first, try the weakening the Choco Chick, then the use your prism.
To claim that mirage for your own. Go on! The select the imprism command.
You might have to try different things before certain mirages will let down their guard and give you a chance to imprism them. Think the outside of the box.
Choco Chick running around in the prismarium.
Pretty the neat, huh? Next, why don't you have a go at stacking that Choco Chick on your head?
Here, watch, I'll just show you.
Oh, now I get it. So when I saw you perched on Lon's head back in Ninewood Hills, that's what you call stacking.
Yep, that's the right. While I'm up to here, I get to take it nice and easy.
Is that stacking or slacking?
When you create a stack, the HP of everyone in the stack gets the added together. Like they say, strength in the numbers.
Oh, so it's like combining into a super robot.
Better than yet, your magic and other abilities have the potential to change too. It all depends on how your stack is configured.
Huh? Oh, I don't need any action figures when I get to blast out super attacks like a super robot.
Well, just be careful. Stacking doesn't make you invincible. Some of the enemy attacks have the power to unstack you.
In other words, bye-bye super robot, so to speak.
Yowzers. That does sound like bad news.
It's true that we are individually the weaker when we're unstacked, but look on the bright side. Since we each get our own the turn in battle, we can use the extra moves to have one member attack and another the heal. It can be very helpful. Depending on the situation, you might even decide to unstack yourselves by choice. Think carefully and choose the best setup for the job.
Can the switch between giant size and Lilla can
depending on your size, you can make different stacks. You aren't allowed to put big things on top of the small things when creating a stack. So, to get on top of a mirage, you need to be in Lilliken form. The best way to learn is to try it once you've rounded up a few more mirages. You'll pick it up in no time.